folks, Greg Rice here at Nexus Property Management, and a great topic that somebody suggested to us. I'm going to go over it right now. But before I do, I just want to let you know, if you have an idea or a topic that you want to see discussed, just post a comment below. And also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you get updated each and every time we post a video. Now, the topic today is, should I rent to my friends and family members? And the short answer, the direct answer, is no, okay? No is a complete sentence, and no is the best and most efficient way to handle that type of situation. The problem is, you think as a property owner, the path of least resistance is the best way for you to handle your property, meaning you want to rent to somebody that you know, that you have experience with, that you have an idea about. But the problem is the back end of that situation. Whenever you rent to a friend or family member, they're likely going to lean on that pre-established relationship at one point or another for their benefit, or to ask for extra time or forgiveness or whatever it may be. And it puts you as the friend or family member in a tough situation, because you don't want to jeopardize that relationship, but you may be losing money. You may be losing time, okay? You're putting yourself in a hole, and they're using you as a crutch to get there. So it's common that we see owners rent to brothers and sisters, and the brother or sister will want an extra month to pay, or an extra week to pay the late fee. Or they want to pay a reduced rent because they've fallen on hard times, or their car is broken, or they have medical bills, whatever it may be. I've seen it time and time again. And the moral of the story is that you go in as friends, but by the end of the tenancy, you leave as enemies. And that's just the way it is. You can't make this mistake of renting to your friends and family members and think that everything's going to be great. I'll see you at the Christmas party, okay? It always ends up in turbulence. It's unavoidable, and the best way to avoid it is to not do it, period. Okay, that's the best way. No friends, no family, you want strangers. And I know that sounds intimidating, you might be nervous, but strangers can't expect anything from you other than a professional business relationship, not a personal relationship. So don't fall into that trap. It'll make yourself harder and more difficult to get out of in the future. Okay? So once again, this is Gregory Rice. We're here at Nexus Property Management, your property managed.